Well, thank you for allowing me to speak tonight, and it's very interesting to see the past 50 years here today in this room and here to hear how you got your start. And so it's a good day that I'm here, and I brought several other community members, citizens, and residents in the state of Florida. We're concerned on this toll road proposal between I-75 and the Gulf of Mexico. And so what I put in your hands today is something that you may or may not have seen. I don't know how many of you read the Florida Phoenix, but this toll road proposal has a lot of nuances that are going to impact our community. And we're very concerned, especially Taylor County in particular, because we are looking at not just the toll road. I am looking at not just the toll road, but I'm also looking at the development and all of the other things that come along with a highway. And so if we're talking about Taylor County, in this particular story that I've just given you, we're concerned at Sheard Island and also Diethel Beach, where there are some of the most polluted waterways in the state of Florida. And across the state of Florida, we have seen polluted waterways already. In the past several years, we have cyanobacteria and waterways that we can no longer use. Why would we want to develop this particular community when it's already a polluted basin off of the Fenn Holloway? So I just wanted to address these concerns, show them to you, knowing what you do. This is what you do planning. And also, why would we want to develop in a hurricane area when we're talking about creating hurricane relief? We want to protect these buffer zones along the Gulf of Mexico instead of destroying them. We also want to protect our corridors. I come from South Florida. I come from Coral Springs. I witnessed what happened to the Sawgrass Expressway, and I'm here to tell you, when they said to the developers, we don't want you building on the other side was referring to the Everglades. Coral Springs was right on the Everglades. And they said, no, we won't build on the other side. We all knew that wasn't going to happen. They went through with this proposal, a toll road also. They built on the other side. They built in the Everglades. So we're looking at this area between, we're looking at the area between Tampa all the way up to Georgia, and very concerned between I-75 and the Gulf of Mexico that you are going to destroy our rural way of life, our wildlife way of life, also the farmlands, and also the communities that would be impacted the most would be communities that do not have a lot of wealth, and this is not an economic opportunity to give these communities wealth. In fact, they'll take it away. Thank you.
Our next speaker is Jim.